and also the Egyptian people. My statement will not be long, but I try to just convey, as my colleague from Malta expressed, convey some messages. I also try to convey some messages. As mentioned in previous statements, that parts of the northern Mediterranean are semi-arid. The southern Mediterranean is arid region. So we need to, considering that in mind, we have many challenges. I will project these challenges on what we are facing. Egypt is vulnerable to climate change, inundation of delta, increase of sea level rise, heat waves that would affect the water consumption, population increase, which is the biggest challenge that I consider. We are expecting our population to reach about 100, from 170 to 180 by 2050. The developments upstream, unilateral action in the upstream of the Nile Basin, this makes our system very sensitive to any changes. Our current water shortage is about 90% of the renewable water resources. This 90% is mitigated by importing virtual water that sums up to 34 billion cubic meters, as well as recycling water that brings our water system overall efficiency is the highest in Africa and one of the highest in the world, and also the water productivity as well. Meeting these challenges actually would require solidarity within the Mediterranean region as well as within the Nile Basin. We are doing our best to resolve or to come up with some reasonable solutions that would not affect seriously our water resources. We need to consider the impact of water shortages on the regional peace and stability and illegal migration. We need to consider the water shortage, the impact of water shortages on the productivity of different countries and its ability to pay the debts. We are hosting here about, I will not say, migrants or refugees. I call them guests. We have about 5 million guests. We are hosting and we are very happy to host them. This puts another pressure on our available water resources. Within the Nile Basin, we are proposing the Victoria Mediterranean Development Corridor that converts the Nile Basin not as a water conveyor, but as a trade corridor and development corridor that would transfer trade and movement of people, tourism, goods, connecting the countries, have real impact on the grassroots and the poor people in the basin. We are very much keen to the development of our region, and especially the Nile Basin. We have built the several dams, but with agreements with the countries, these dams does not have significant impact on us. We are working with our colleagues in the Nile Basin, especially in Ethiopia and Sudan, to mitigate or minimize the severe impact of the Gerda dam. And we hope in the near future we'll reach some reasonable, fair agreements on the operation and filling and operation of the dam in synchronization with other dams. With this, I would conclude my little statement, and I wish you very successful discussions and deliberations within this forum or meeting or conference. Thank you very much.